soft as an easy chair. Love fresh as the morning air. One love that is shared by two.
We are with the completion of the painting, taking 48 hours. Tess and John. Tess has a great history, and she's such a caring and loving person. She went to Catholic grade school, Catholic high school, and then later Catholic college, and she was a teacher at our very own St. Anne's Catholic Church in Palm Beach. John ran the restaurant, John and G's, for many years, both him and his wife, and his children. They're both giving and very caring. In fact, they donated to the Hospice of Palm Beach, and they had one day where they donated all their receipts on their 40th anniversary of the restaurant, when they had 40-cent sliders, Detroit sliders, and everything went to the Hospice Society. They're such caring and loving people. I am so glad to give this painting to their family and to John and G's restaurant. We are at the start of John and Tess's painting. You know, painting is very much like music. With music, you start out with silence, and then you have a melody, an instrumental, and a vocal layer over layer to make a beautiful song. With painting, you start with a blank canvas, and you have layer over layer of imaging and color. What I'm working on right now is the flowers in the bottom left side of the painting. And about a half an hour ago, I did some work on the face, did the drawing of the face, of Teresa's face, and also the preliminary painting of John's face, which just as Rembrandt Van Ryan
under dark
painted
clothing.
His undertone of clothing as an orange amber tone, I will paint her sweater as an undertone of orange amber, and his jacket would be an undertone of blue. Flowers in front are symbolic of the flowers at Johnny G's restaurant. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to start painting the blue on the faces. People just don't understand the blue on the faces, but that's what Rembrandt Van Ryan always did. He always painted the blue undertone under the faces, because our skin is naturally blue on our veins under the skin. And then I'll paint a transparent glaze of skin tone over the blue. Here we are, painting the transparent blue over the amber tone of the sweater. Remember, it's layer over layer transparent glaze. That's what gives my paintings the three-dimensional look. That is what gives Rembrandt the three-dimensional look. Using the brown for the hair. What we're doing now is mixing up the flesh tones and applying it to the blue undertone on the face. The blue undertone, people say, why blue? Well, Rembrandt Van Ryan knew that this looked as realistic as possible. He would have a blue undertone and transparent glaze of a flesh tone over the blue. It gave it a three-dimensional life look effect. Now, in Tess's painting, on Teresa's painting, I referenced her yearbooks from 1948 at St. Mary's Academy, as well as the University of Michigan, Marygrove College, and she also was a teacher at St. Anne's Catholic Church in Palm Beach. Those yearbooks had some pretty good pictures of her. And here we are, we're going to mix up the flesh tones, the three colors, and then apply that flesh tone over the blue, around the edges of the face. And you'll slowly see the flesh tones come out lighter and lighter. Here we are painting the lighter tone to the skin. More detail on the face here, coming up. Now this is one of the most important parts of the Rembrandt painting, is putting the thin glaze of amber tone over the edge of the face. And then we kind of wipe off gently where we want the highlights to come through to the flesh tones. And the skin looks so real. This is the joy for me, seeing the final result. And next thing I'm going to do is a lot of things that people may say, well, what in the heck were you thinking about when you put a little green around the edges? Well, the green, the technique that Rembrandt used, he used a light green amber tone to put around the corner of the eyes and the corner of the jaw. This green amber tone Rembrandt always used was to bring in the outside light. He knew that with amber light, which they used back in 1660, would always reflect a little bit of the outside trees and grass, which gave it an absolute three-dimensional, translucent, beautiful skin effect. The little green along the edges, you don't really notice it, but it's there. But now you will notice it, to give it a real human look on these two beautiful people. Now we're going to add the absolute highlights for the tip of the nose and for the teeth. And a beautiful sparkle in Tess's eyes and John's eyes. Highlight for the ears. Beautiful couple, Tess and John. Tess has dedicated much of her life to Christian teaching both in grade school, high school, and at St. Anne's Catholic School in Palm Beach. The painting's completed in 48 hours, 2 days. They say that life is God's gift to us, but what we do with that life is our gift to God. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure doing this couple's painting. I hope Johnny G's restaurant and the Johnny G's family enjoy it. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Love ageless and the